Hi, welcome. This is Dr. John DeMartini. This is one of the most amazing and inspiring shows that you can listen into. If you want to be on the edge of your seats, if you want to open up your heart, if you want to expand your mind, and you want to meet incredible people, stay tuned because you're just about to experience a transformative radio show that will change your life. And you're listening to the Dr. Pat Show is coming up right next.
Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show, talk radio to thrive by. Powerful, inspiring, and coming to you live, bringing you stories of people like you and me, busting through and living life full out. Get ready to dare to wonder what your life would be like if you knew you could not fail. Hey, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Dr. Pat Show. My voice is a little scratchy today. Scratchy. Welcome, everybody.
Rough Mother's Day weekend or something?
Yeah. What a mother. I'm telling you.
What a mother. That's right.
That's what I'm saying. Yes. I was growling to Janis Joplin's and Bobby McGee.
Oh, no.
Busted out of Baton Rouge, waiting for a train. Remember that one?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah. Wow. Then there were a couple of others that brought me way back in time. Went to a very special event, super duper fun event in Port Townsend on, when did I go? Oh, Saturday. What a gorgeous day. Today's a gorgeous day. And Benny, I don't know if you saw this, but there were two eagles flying out there outside at about 10:30 this morning out there, just right outside your window. Two of them big.
Awesome.
Big. We see the eagles all the time from here because we are in the studio in Seattle, KKNW AM 1150. And then Chris across the plains from Westerly, Rhode Island, he sees the ocean. Did you know that Westerly, Rhode Island is right there on the Atlantic?
I did not know that.
Yeah, it is. So I don't know if he hits the Atlantic directly. I have to ask Chris this question. Chris, if you're listening, we need some information. I don't know if that is the Atlantic or if that's the sound. You see, isn't it interesting that I do two radio shows, both of them may be on a sound.
It was meant to be.
This is a Puget Sound.
It was meant to be.
The other one, I think, is Long Island Sound, although I don't really want to tick off all the people in Westerly, Rhode Island by saying something that is not true. But from the map, it looks a little soundish. What a great day. It looks soundish. We're doing a little soundish
today. I like
today.
That. That's just how it
we're just to do this. This is the soundish network.
No.
KKNW is alternative soundish. It sounds like a whole.
I don't want you to say it because, unfortunately, there might be one already out there.
You think there is?
It's possible, Pat. There's
seriously?
So much out. Yeah, sure.
You think so?
No, I don't know. I'm not saying anything.
You're not saying?
No.
Did you have a good Mother's Day?
I did.
How was the Mother's Day?
It was
for the mom.
Really well. Lindsay, of course, the new mother as of 16 months ago.
Yeah.
To my beautiful little buggers. We had a great day. We spent time with my mom and my side of the family. We did Lindsay's family the week before, so we can combine both.
Oh, nice.
And I just went to the park, hung out. We tried Cool On, but it was packed, so we decided to go somewhere else. And much easier. Just kind of hung out.
Did you have barbecue?
No, we just had a little picnic.
Picnic's good.
Yeah, my
brother.
Yeah, you rarely get to do those. You know, everyone wants to bring out the briquettes and blah blah blah. It's like, you know, go simple. So
that's right.
My brother-in-law brought and packed up the picnic for everybody. So thanks, Burton.
Somebody sent me an email. Said Benny, I don't know if this is true. I don't even know if this is even possible. Somebody sent me an email. Asked me had I heard about. I guess they heard us talking about barbecue. Asked me a question.
That was me.
Okay,
you're always talking about barbecue.
I am talking about barbecue. Because I'm from Jersey.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about eating it all the
time. We're in New Jersey. Everybody in Jersey's got a barbecue almost. They said to me, Dr. Pat, have you heard about the solar barbecue?
I don't know about that.
I have never heard of that, though. Have you heard of a solar?
I'd have to see it in action.
Have you heard of a solar barbecue?
Jump on board. I'm sure
I guess
works under the same.
It's electric.
Yeah.
I guess it's like electric, you know, not really like. Like
it uses the solar energy
solar
and produces
energy, but
electricity.
It's got an electric grill thing. You know, like an electric stove.
Or like a rotisserie or something like that.
Thank you.
I'd have to look
much.
Into it.
Solar barbecue. Now, guess what? If they don't exist, who out there now is going to go out and get that patent for that solar barbecue?
I'm sure it already has.
What a great idea, though. Think about it. I mean, it's not going to give you the flavor.
See, that's of what the I'm going to. I'll define. You know, back yeah. the years of me and my meat days. I guess I'm on the grill. I'm sorry, but cooking it over from the briquettes, the charcoal to the, you know, the gas and whatever's convenient. But you've got that built-in oomph from just flames.
Exactly.
Not
okay.
from the electric.
Okay. So,
current.
Yeah. But okay. So. It's nothing better than eating a hamburger that tastes like charcoal briquettes and lighter fluid. Mm. Just absolutely right up there with the top of the.
But it's also the situation because then you got your dad yelling. And like,
you should have seen my dad do the charcoal briquettes. Holy, you know what?
Like one briquette with like a gallon of.
Oh, my God. He would soak. The charcoal briquettes.
You'd have to. They don't start on their own.
I'm telling you, he would. But you have to understand the kind of thing that we grow up with, right? Not only did we get it. Did you see the Godfather movie?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Do you remember the part in the Godfather where Marlon Brando just drops dead, and you know that he dies, he gets a heart attack or something, and the little kid is running around. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Did you see what the little kid had in the little can, the spray can?
No.
That is DDT. That is
everybody
sprayed the tomatoes.
Right. Like in the what is it? The stainless steel kind of pumper spray thing?
That was in The Godfather.
Really?
Perfect.
Is that what that
perfect
was?
Perfect thing of what went on then. And now we wonder why we have allergies. You all out here that in Pacific Northwest. You probably have not experienced this, but, you know, those of you that come, I don't know about Chris. Chris would know what I'm talking about, too. But I don't think you did stuff like that. I think you had a little bit more of something with nature than I did growing up. I think you had a little bit more. I mean, basically, people tell me that this whole area 30 years ago was nothing, didn't look anything like this at all. I know you were barely born then, but.
I wasn't even here. I was even in a smaller place.
Where were you?
Alaska.
Oh, you were in you were in Alaska. Oh.
I was from a real small town.
A real small town?
Mm-hmm.
Did you have barbecue there?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. But then back then, didn't you just light a house on fire?
Pretty
something?
Much, yeah. Entire
like,
acre.
Hey,
an entire acre.
We got to get some warmth out here.
Yeah.
Interesting, though. What a fabulous weekend. But anyway, I was up in Port Townsend. And there's a community in Port Townsend. And they had... what they call the Port Townsend Review. They had a review. It was a talent show.
Wow. Did you enter?
Like what?
I don't know. You sing quite a bit on here.
I was singing Janis Joplin, me and Bobby McGee.
That's fine. Whatever works for you.
In the background, but I wasn't on stage. So these were really talented. It was funny. It was hysterical. What a great job. Hats off to Port Townsend. Boy, I'll tell you, you all got it going. Anybody, for those of you that ever want to come out to the Seattle area, if you're listening to this show from other places, yes, Seattle is beautiful. There's no question about it. But I will tell you that once you venture out of Seattle and you go north or south or even east, right, there's some beautiful country. If you hop yourself on a ferry, I'm going to tell you, every one of you out there that is thinking, I'm going to go to Seattle, get yourself on a ferry. And get over to Port Townsend. And if you have some time, just make sure you make a reservation and stay there. Amazing, amazing place. I think that Port Townsend is considered in part of the Sun Belt of the state of Washington. But anyway, we've got a really important show today. Lyme Time Part 2. Lyme Disease. Lyme Time Part 2. This is a follow-up. With Dr. Ronnie DeLuz joining us here today. And we're going to be following up with her as well as a special guest. Co-guest on the show, which is Dr. Haller. And so we're just going to take a short break in a minute here. And hopefully we're going to get them on the show because where'd they be? Dr. Ronnie, come on. We need to talk about this. We're going to be talking about Lyme disease and, you know, why, as Dr. Ronnie would say, a disaster to your lifestyle. It changes your lifestyle. Dr. Ronnie, of course, from Martha's Vineyard Holistic Retreat. She specializes in chronic conditions and is a master. Her retreat centers and the various levels of retreats that she does, people walk in there, barely walking in there, and they walk out with a new life. And, you know, you've heard Dr. Ronnie before talk about, you know, why that is, her own personal healing journey, and, you know, how her struggles really catapulted her to go back to school and to really take on some of the most chronic diseases we have right now. So, you know, sometimes we learn from the disaster. The question is, do we always get the lesson? This is what I've been asking myself. You know, what is this lesson? What is it that I am supposed to be learning that I'm not getting just yet? I wonder what that is. But I hope all of you had a fabulous Mother's Day, like Benny did, Benny the boys and his sweetie. And boy, they're getting big. What'd you say? They're 16 months?
Yeah. So they're probably around 25, maybe 30 pounds.
Well, and I want
to. Still flexing them, but man, they're getting tough.
Well, I want to tell you that Kamisha, our Kamisha,
mm-hmm.
made it just in time.
Yeah.
By giving birth.
Yay.
She made it.
Then there's me. I've got two of them going at once.
You should play that in stereo.
It is in stereo. Now I got them both.
Both of them, like harmony. Get, like, do a little harmony clip of that. Kamisha gave birth. Hallelujah, sister. I was not ready to have not one more conversation with Kamisha about this little baby that absolutely decided to come out whenever he was ready. Malcolm Caleb Houston Woods. Hallelujah, Malcolm. Thank you. 8 pounds, 4 ounces, 21 inches. Came through on Saturday. We all feeling that? Came through on Saturday. What does that mean if Malcolm came on Saturday? What did that make Kamisha? A mother on Mother's Day. She got a twofer. All right. All right, everybody. Take a short break. We'll be right back with the Dr. Pat Show.
Bobby thumbed a diesel down just before it rained and rode us all the way to New Orleans. I pulled my harpoon out of my dirty red bandana. I was playing soft while Bobby sang the blues. Windshield wipers slapping time. I was holding Bobby's hand in mine. We sang every song that Javi knew.
Are the magic and mysteries of Egypt calling you? Picture yourself standing between the paws of the Sphinx, meditating inside the Great Pyramid and other sacred temples and exclusive visits. Imagine cruising down the Nile on a luxurious private sailing yacht and exploring the peaceful countryside of Egypt. If you're interested in travel that expands, transforms, and rejuvenates you, join Dr. Friedemann Schaub and Danielle Rama Hoffman, author of The Temples of Light, for a spiritual and healing journey to Egypt this September. Call for more information, 866-903-6463. That's 866-903-6463. Or visit EgyptIsCalling.com. That's EgyptIsCalling.com.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all. A healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. Hi, this is Dr. Darvish. If you have not found an answer to your chronic symptoms, you will find answers here at Holistic Medical Center. Our doctors find the root cause of your symptoms and guide your body towards healing naturally. We transform lives from within. Visit us at drdarvish.com. drdarvish.com.
What are we attracting in our life and relationships, and why? And how can we let go of attracting and being attracted to things that may not serve us? Peter Kane has been facilitating deep relationship work for over 30 years. Author of The Monogamy Challenge, Creating and Keeping Intimacy, Peter is passionate about bringing aliveness into your life and relationships. Contact Peter Kane for counseling, coaching, or breathwork. Visit peterkane.org or contact Peter Kane at 425-802-2050.
Hi, I'm Dr. Pat, and I want to share something amazing with you. If you're sick of information and ready for an extreme transformation, then check out world-renowned energy healer Ann Taylor at FasterQuickerBetter.com. She's been creating miracles in tens of thousands of people's lives for over 16 years, and I'm one of those people. You too can easily do the same by simply listening to her recordings. If you want to miraculously eliminate fears, worries, and negative beliefs, then you owe it to yourself to purchase her amazing package, which includes over 50 pieces of healing work. Thanks to Ann's 60-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. Hurry over to FasterBetterQuicker.com and finally experience the quantum leap in consciousness that you truly deserve.
Yesterday, to be holding Bobby's body next to mine. Freedom is just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing. That's all that Bobby left
me. Feeling good is easy love when he sang the blues. Feeling good is good enough for me.
Is that the raspiness that starts there?
You got the chorus? I can get real raspy on you. All right, everybody, come on, sing along. Oh, my God. Janice, why did you have to leave? Dang. I was a Janice groupie. I'm sorry.
Couldn't tell at all.
I'm sorry. I was. I have. You know how many times I got to see Janice Joplin?
Ooh. Well, you're a product from the 60s.
Thank you. I'm a product.
Yeah.
That's so, me. I'm a product.
So probably quite a few. I'm just going to throw it out there.
My new name. When you call into the show, just say, "Hey, Dr. Product." I love that. Drank beer out of the same can when I was drinking. I'm surprised I got
that with the pull tabs, the pull tab beer.
Oh my God! How did you know?
I've seen photos.
And I think it was at the time when there was only one beer.
It passed around between 20 people.
Rolling Rock was the.
There's got to be more than just that one.
Oh, it's funny.
All right, well, I'll do some
research.
Crack research on it.
Yeah, you know, we're not going back to the Paleolithic era here. Lyme Time Part 2. You know, big conversation. Growing every minute of every day. Dr. Ronnie DeLuce joining us here today. Dr. Enid Haller as well. Dr. Ronnie, great to have you here. Dr. Haller, great to have you here. This is a conversation that just will not go away. Thank you for helping it not go away. Dr. Ronnie.
Thank you. I mean, if it wasn't for you, I couldn't get the message out. But, you know, let me tell you, Lyme is scary, isn't it? And you know what? Why? It's because we need information. We want information because when I talk about Lyme, the first thing they say is, okay, how can you help us? How can you help the doctors to help us? How can you help us? And the one thing that I keep saying is that you have to be proactive. You got to join support groups. You got to get online. And that's why I'm so grateful for Dr. Haller, because she is well-versed, more well-versed than I am about Lyme. She has in her pocket organizations, different Lyme specialists around the country that can help you. So there is hope. The information that we have gathered since our last session, I want to tell you, is amazing. We've done some real work to help people, and we're ready. And I never wanted to be the type of person that put a pandemic out there.
Yeah.
There's hope. Whenever I talk about something, I want to make sure that I have the answer or part of the answer, or at least give people hope that there will be some answers. And that's what we've done for people.
Great.
So are you ready?
I'm ready. Let's go.
Okay, Dr. Haller. I would love for her to start.
Yes. What? Hi, everybody.
Welcome to the show.
Dr. Pitt, thank you for having us for part two of Lyme Time. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
There is so much information to share with people. The last show, I remember that you asked me to look into what the West Coast was like as far as understanding, you know, how to find a Lyme literate doctor anywhere in the mm-hmm. United States, not just the West Coast.
Right.
But also, you know, what are the stages involved if you suspect that you have Lyme mm-hmm. and you're not getting any help from your general practitioner? And I think one of the major things that people don't understand is that there are three stages of Lyme disease. There is the acute phase, there is the intermediate stage, and the chronic stage. And these three stages are something that the Center for Disease Control, the CDC, and the IDSA are not completely recognizing
for some reason. That's right.
And we're not sure why that is. But so the fallacy around Lyme disease, the problem that we have is that people are feeling ill. They're feeling sick. They don't know what to do. They go to their general practitioner. Their general practitioner says, well, let's do a Lyme test. They do a Lyme test, and then it comes back negative. The problem then being is that they say, okay, you don't have Lyme disease, and they go away. Well, one of the problems that we have with that thing playing out the way it's playing out all over the country is that our Lyme test is not good in our hospital. It's inadequate. So a lot of people are walking away actually positive with Lyme disease. Then that allows the Lyme to turn into the next phase, which is the second phase of Lyme disease, which is the intermediate phase,
mm-hmm.
where it starts to attack your heart and joints and muscles and any other organ it can start to move into. If you carry Lyme disease for over a year, it turns into a chronic situation. So a lot of these people are walking away from their general practitioners or from their hospital, and they're thinking they don't have Lyme, and yet they do, and they're getting sicker and sicker by the moment. There are tests that are better for Lyme disease that we spoke a little bit about last time, and we talked about the Igenix test, which I think is mm-hmm. the most popular one and mm-hmm. is accepted by insurance companies now. There are other tests in the works right now, one out of Texas and one out of Pennsylvania,
mm-hmm.
that one is a DNA test for Lyme, which has to be approved still, but the man who developed it has been working on it for over 7 years.
Okay.
And this test should prove that you could find the actual spirochete in your system.
Mm-hmm.
The blood test that Dr. Burascano, who is the godfather of Lyme disease, chronic Lyme, He has developed a test out of Pennsylvania now that's brand new, yet it still needs to be accepted by the community, the medical community, which is pending right now. But you are able to get this test, and I will, at the end of the show, I will give you all the information about that. But basically, that will also check your blood to see if the spirochete is present or has ever been present, and is a highly specialized test that is the first time that we've basically had a test like this that will actually tell you yes or no definitively if you have Lyme disease. That we have not had yet until this point. So that could actually change the entire climate of chronic Lyme in this country once that test is approved. Now, the other thing that I wanted to touch on today is that finding a chronic Lyme doctor is what you need. So if you are in the chronic phase, is trickier than people realize.
Right.
The main way that you can find one is there are several websites I wanted to make sure that people write down that are very important for starting to do their own work and being their own advocate with Lyme disease, because that's what actually happens when you suspect you have chronic Lyme. No, not a lot of people are going to help you.
Right, and a lot of people are going to publicize that they treat it, right?
Correct.
Right, and you'll talk about why that is.
That is exactly right. Because of the political issue behind Lyme disease, that these four doctors in some states, it's illegal for them to practice on chronic Lyme patients, and they have to basically operate under the radar. So that's why it's hard to find them. these websites are the most important, valuable thing that I can hand out to you today, because it will enable people to find the proper doctor near them to hopefully get a correct diagnosis and then start their treatment and to, you know, getting better with the Lyme disease. Otherwise, they are going to keep getting worse every day. The CDC, Centers for Disease Control, and the IDSA are not necessarily our friends in this matter. They are actually fighting this in Congress right now as we speak. They need to, there are congressmen there that are trying to get the laws changed and the guidelines changed, but it is still, it still hasn't happened. So that's why we have this political issue. The very good Lyme disease network is called the Lyme Disease Network, which is www.lymenet, that's LYMENET.org. That is an excellent source to find a Lyme literate doctor in your area. The other one is Turn the Corner Foundation, which is a very, very helpful organization that Amy Tan founded.
Mm-hmm.
She's, came down with Lyme disease, and that is turnthecornerfoundation.org. There is a very good organization called CALDA, C-A-L-D-A, that people would want to log into as well. That's the California Lyme Disease Association. And then ILADS is the last one, I-L-A-D-S. ILADS.org, and that is the International Lyme Disease and Associated Disorders. And those, I would say, four websites are extremely valuable for people who suspect that they have Lyme disease and they're getting sicker every day.
Wow.
So logging on to those would be very helpful.
Wow. Let's take a short break. When we come back, Dr. Holler, Dr. Ronnie are going to join us here. Ronnie DeLuz is going to join us here today. We're going to go through and talk about what a typical Lyme protocol looks like, how is it covered in long-term treatment, what Dr. Ronnie, Dr. Holler are doing about it, and how these different kinds of retreats can help you and actually help you get to the place where you figure out what's going on with your body. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with the Dr. Pat Show.
Gratitude, asks the heart. Tell me, who are you? I would like to meet you and get to know you better. Gratitude responds, I am that which strikes at your door and waits until you open it with grace. I am that which only wants to partner with you at any moment. I am that which wishes your expansion more than anything. Gratitude is on a mission to create a partnership between the hearts of all human beings. Wouldn't it be wonderful to cultivate this state of being every single day? Stimulate the energy of the essence of gratitude in your life while bathing in this wonderful and powerful vibration with our diamond combo, and transform your life in health, creativity, wealth, and enriched relationships. Visit our Gratitude Living Boutique at explorationgratitude.com.
Get inspired. Create the life you desire with internationally known radio host and motivational speaker, Sue London. Sue inspires millions of people to overcome difficult or traumatic situations in their lives. People feel hope, courage, and are ready to move forward after hearing Sue speak. Book motivational speaker Sue London for your next event at AskSueLondon.com. That's AskSueLondon.com.
Have you ever wanted to join a yoga class, yet felt self-conscious or simply didn't have the time? Now you can bring live Kundalini yoga into your home with KRI-certified Dr. Ann Taylor. You will learn a scientific technology of movement, mantra, meditation, and breathing techniques designed to balance your mind, body, and spirit. Sign up today for our free newsletter and receive your first class free. Visit Ann with an E, Taylor.com.
Naturopathic doctor, founder of the Martha's Vineyard Holistic Retreat, and author of the New York Times bestseller, 21 Pounds in 21 Days, Dr. Ronnie DeLuce has helped tens of thousands of people, including celebrities and athletes, with her message of lifestyle change. Now Dr. Ronnie DeLuce wants to help you. You too can be saved. Email Dr. Ronnie DeLuce at info@ronniedeluceonradio.com and visit mvholisticretreat.com. Dr. Ronnie DeLuce, your partner in wellness.
Are you feeling stuck? Do you want to be free from fears and doubts and finally feel good about yourself, but you just don't know how to get there? Dr. Schaub's Accelerated Breakthrough Program provides you with the tools and solutions to go beyond your limitations and achieve self-empowered confidence. Call for your free phone consultation at 866-903-MIND. Visit CellularWisdom.com. That's CellularWisdom.com.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back. Welcome back to the Dr. Pat Show. This is what we promised everybody out there. It's a conversation about Lyme disease, Lyme Time, part two. And many of you that have been listening to the show for a really long time know that we did an entire series, brought the film Under Our Skin out here to the state of Washington. I don't really have to really talk much to the people in Westerly, Rhode Island, and Chris and the gang and Ronnie and Dr. Haller. And I mean, you know, they live in the East Coast surrounding area. Our beloved Carrie O'Connor, Connecticut. So, you know, there is a sense of awareness that goes on in the Northeast that is unlike anywhere else when it comes to Lyme disease. And here more recently, we on the West Coast in Washington State, California, Oregon, you know, we have gotten a lot of information because there have been so many incidences of this. Now, if you're anywhere in the middle of the country, it is a journey. It is a journey. And we have lost people. For example, if you saw the movie Under Our Skin, there's a segment that takes place in Minnesota where they're kind of celebrating the anniversary. The woman that's actually in that film passed away 2 weeks prior to her actually getting on a plane and coming up here to see Dr. Darvish. So this is the kind of thing we're talking about. Many of you have called into the show, have had chronic Lyme right here, and understand the difficulty that this brings. Also part of the challenge, as you'll hear from Dr. Haller and Dr. Ronnie, is that the diagnosis is tricky, if not impossible. Thank you both for joining the show today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's start to talk about, this idea of protocol. And I made a statement that, you know, most of the attention that people are really getting are from people on the East Coast, doctors on the East Coast. Most of the controversy and challenges are also with those doctors on the East Coast. But, you know, there have been many solutions to this that both you, Dr. Haller, and Dr. Ronnie have been able to come up with. Let's talk about what kinds of things have you both discovered works in this area?
I'll answer it first, and then Ronnie, you jump in after me. Is that okay?
Sure.
The most successful treatment that I have found going to several Lyme doctors here in the East Coast is a holistic treatment. It's looking at the whole picture. It's when the doctor, and it's usually a Lyme doctor or someone that knows Lyme, like Dr. Ronnie knows Lyme very well, actually, from a treatment standpoint. She knows that basically getting the immune system healthy is one of the keys to getting better with chronic Lyme disease. And so where I went for treatment in New York with Dr. Richard Horowitz, he looks at, he's also in the movie, Under Our Skin. He looks at the whole picture. He looks at the heavy metals. He treats that. He looks at the diet. He tells you how to eat better and exactly how you're supposed to eat, which is like a lot of times a gluten-free diet for 3 months to get the sugar completely out of your diet because the spirochetes love sugar, to adjust basically Anything that goes into your mouth, you know, to really analyze it and figure out what's your new diet is extremely important. The other thing is he likes to detoxing things like the infrared, far infrared sauna, something called a biomat, which is also a far infrared treatment that you can actually buy this mat and do it at home. And it really kills the spirochetes because it cooks them. They don't like a high heat. And Ronnie will talk more about that.
I like the idea. We should cook them all.
Yeah, you have to cook them.
Let's bring out the holistic barbecue right now, folks. That's what I'm saying. Well, okay, so you know what? Let's make it, you know, Dr. Heller, here's what I would love to see happen with those biomats.
Yeah.
Somebody needs to get a hold of these biomat people and say, you know what? If you would drop the price of this, we would become massive spokespeople for you.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you could create a nonprofit for these things, we would support you. Because you're right. There are things out there that are absolutely cooking them. And we just need to make this so that people, regardless of what they're going through, can afford them. Because you two know that when you go down this journey with Lyme disease, it is an expensive one. Correct, ladies?
Very, very expensive. And I never wanted to, you know, the retreat on Martha's Vineyard, and I'm trying to get the word out, is that I was so happy to join Dr. Howler's support group.
Mm.
And I've done, you know, just about, I've cut my prices in half. I'm doing a lot of barter because I'm committed to helping the support group to get them to understand the holistic view. Because like Dr. Harler said, holistically is the way to go with this because it's whole body disease. You know, Lyme is sometimes classified as having different stages. And we like to call it early versus chronic, but there's three different stages. And a lot of people that I talk to, they only want to talk to me about the first stage, you know. Well, I didn't have that bull's eye rash, so the doctor says I'm fine. But we now know, we're more well-versed in this, that there's another stage called secondary Lyme disease, which affects the nervous system, the muscular skeletal system, the cardiac system. So there's classifications of this, and if it affects that particular part of your body, your symptoms are going to be just about mostly cardiac. It's cardiac Lyme. It's going to be palpitation. You're going to have no energy. You're going to have lack of oxygen. So whole body and holistic point of view is the best way, because I've talked to several doctors around the country that is doing this, and we found that they're more hopeful that way, because we have to deal with the immune system so that the immune system may be less able to respond if the person is having a hard time clearing toxins. If you're having a difficult time clearing toxins, then we have to deal with the immune system. And we use some acupuncture, and we use a lot of juicing and detoxification of different organs. We use probiotics. It's not just antibiotics anymore.
No.
Antibiotics is really ruining the immune system. So we have to get the word out that antibiotics will not only give you a lower immune, but it takes away all the flora from out of your colon. I have one particular client that have Lyme that have so much gastrointestinal problems that you can't eat anything. So we have to zero in on the gastrointestinal system. If we have somebody with a lot of neurological system because of neurological Lyme, we have to zero in on that. So as time goes on, we will see a lot of different symptoms all over the body, and that's why we call it a whole body illness or a whole body disease. And that's how each individual holistic doctor is attacking it. So one person may be different from another person depending on their symptoms. So like I said at the first part, sometimes we have three or four different doctors dealing with chronic Lyme. And what we're trying to become really good at is working with these different doctors around the country so that we can help people.
Well, I mean, this is really you know, for those people that are listening, that either, you know, what's interesting, this is like the idea of corporate downsizing. It used to be, not too long ago, by the way, that you didn't hardly know anybody that lost their job through downsizing, right?
Right.
Now you not only know them, You know their children that are part of this. This is the same as Lyme. You know, if you take the same approach, you hardly knew anyone that had it or talked about it. It didn't happen. But what we did know, and Dr. Ronnie, you and I talked about this. Dr. Holler, you need to jump in. What we did discover and are discovering is the rise in autoimmune disease.
Right.
I wonder what that's about.
That's right.
It's
amazing that everybody that comes to the retreat has one, at least one autoimmune. I had one lady had all three.
I'm going,
you have lupus, multiple sclerosis, and rheumatoid arthritis at age 52?
Wow.
You gotta wonder what's going on.
Right.
And, you know, the other thing I was telling someone, you know, Lyme, it's an epidemic. And in order to get it under control, and I give it to you, in about 3 years, we're going to have so many different names for this disease.
Because
it's an epidemic, that's what they do. It's an epidemic, so they're going to start breaking it up in different names.
Yeah. And the high misdiagnosis rate is so extremely high with all these other disorders because chronic Lyme is not acknowledged yet in most states, still not accepted. So the doctors have to put a label on you somehow. And if they don't put a label on you, if it's MS or Parkinson's or one of these other autoimmune diseases, they start to treat you for these diseases with a lot of the times the wrong medication. I can't tell you how many people in my Lyme support group that I've had over the last couple of years come in with a different diagnosis of fibromyalgia or MS, and they were treated for these other disorders for years until they actually found out. A lot of the times, I also want to say that doctors tend to, because of the pain involved with Lyme disease, they're in really chronic pain, they tend to give you steroids, which is actually one of the worst things you can do for Lyme disease because it actually suppresses the immune system, the steroids. It's not the best thing, and it makes it weakens the immune system more. So steroids almost puts, many Lyme patients into a nosedive and makes them much worse, and a lot of our doctors don't know that. That brings me to one more point I want to make is that the website that I mentioned before, ILAD, which is the International Lyme Disease and Associated Disorders, is one of the best organizations for Lyme, has a training program for doctors. So if you go to your general practitioner, you love your general practitioner, he knows nothing about Lyme, and it's not illegal in your state, which you have to find out from, your bylaws.
Right.
But if it is legal in your state, which it is becoming more and more prevalent, more states are, ruling that it's okay for doctors to treat chronic Lyme.
Right, right.
You can ask your general practitioner to go to the training program at ILAD, or they have a doctor come to them to train them how to treat chronic Lyme.
Well, let's talk about this when we come back from break a little bit more, because it is all part of that. But here's what's happening for those of you out there. Just got an instant message. Yes, go to the website underourskin.com. But also take a look at the blog, because what you're going to find, the latest news as of April this month, is an initiative by the IDSA to stop the television broadcast of this film. To stop it. And who are the IDSA people? Infectious Disease Society of America. They have come out to stop any of the screenings, any of the television broadcasts of Under Our Skin. Can you believe that? Stay tuned, everyone. We'll be right back.
Change your coffee experience forever with Camino Island Coffee Roaster. Fair trade, certified organic, shade-grown delicious coffee. The Camino Island Coffee Roasters are giving back. Receive a free pound of the most popular single origin coffee, Papua New Guinea, to the first 250 callers. The number is toll-free, 855-438-8671. Just pay $8.95 shipping and handling, and you can try triple certified coffee for yourself. The number is toll-free, 855-438-8671. This is a free pound of coffee that retails at $16.95. Once you've tried this coffee, you will automatically be enrolled in the Coffee Lovers Club for free and will always receive free shipping and nearly 30% off retail of your coffee orders. This coffee is going to knock your socks off. That number again is 855-GET-TOP-1. We say top one because this coffee is the top 1% grade. That's 855-438-8671.
Hi, my name is Dr. Dane here from Access Consciousness. Are you a seeker, a dreamer, one of those people who's always known that there should be greater possibilities available but haven't yet been able to create it as your life? I'd like to help. Go to creatinggreaterpossibilities.com, where there's a free video and audio series created especially for you. Once again, creatinggreaterpossibilities.com. It's free, and it's designed to give you the actual tools that you need to create the life you've always been looking for. creatinggreaterpossibilities.com.
The Ascension Foundation, serving to build an interdimensional community. The Ascended Masters invite you to join them in co-creating this mission. Allow the Masters to lead the way in activating the wisdom of your heart consciousness and raising your vibration. You can communicate with them directly by attending apportation events and classes in mediumship, crystal light energy healing, alchemy, master studies, past life regression, and more. For a schedule of classes, workshops, and special events, visit theascensionfoundation.com. That's theascensionfoundation.com.
I'm Dr. Pat Baccili, the host of the Dr. Pat Show, talk radio to thrive by. Let me help you take your empowering message to a community of people looking for products and services that value all life on earth and tap into the one true freedom we have, the freedom to choose. Let our listeners choose you. Join the buzz and be the buzz. Sponsor the Dr. Pat Show. Call me at 206-523-5522. That's 206-523-5522.
If you or anyone you love has a degenerative or bulging disc, you need to know the doctors at Wellness One of Bellevue and Eastgate. For bulging discs of the back and neck, they use the DRX-9000 spinal decompression machine. It gently creates negative pressure on the specific degenerated disc that allows the body to naturally repair itself. No drugs and no surgery. The website is bellevue.wellness1.net to learn more about spinal decompression at Wellness One of Bellevue and Eastgate. That's bellevue.wellness1.net.
Busted flat in Baton Rouge, waiting for a train. And I was feeling near as faded as my jeans. Bobby thumbed a diesel down just before it rained. And rode us all the way to New Orleans.
Here we go.
I pulled my harpoon and my dirty red bandana. I was playing soft when Bobby sang the blues. Yeah. Windshield wiper slapping time. Bobby's hitting my. We sang every song that time I knew.
All right. Yeah, freedom is another word for nothing less to lose. Let me tell you something. Nothing left to lose. Let me tell you something. That line and that song, freedom is another word for nothing left to lose. Very interesting quote by Miss Janice. There's nothing more important. And those of you that listen to the show and have not been feeling so well these days, it's nothing more important than getting your health back. You know, there's such freedom in that. It doesn't matter where you are in the health journey, whether, you know, it's chronic or acute. You know what it's like when you get down a court. Having Lyme disease is not about getting down a court. It's about not even having a fuel system that works. Dr. Ronnie, Dr. Howler, thank you for joining me here today. Take a minute, give out your websites, and then let's talk about what people should be doing, what they could do.
Okay, go to MV for Martha's Vineyard, holisticretreat.com, and join the retreat newsletter. We are planning on putting out a lot of information about Lyme and other chronic illnesses that are plaguing people today that are growing faster than I can even say it. So mvholisticretreat.com. My email, if you have any specific questions, because that's what I do all night, answer emails, is drronnie@mvholisticretreat.com. I'll be more than happy to answer your question. And later on, I'm going to give out a really good natural tick repellent. Should I do that now?
Yes.
I'd love to do that. I went to take my son to the dermatologist last week just for some general rash on his legs that came from mosquito bites or last year. So he got some dark spots. And as we went to the doctor's, and he sits down in a chair, and I go, what's that thing on your leg, your jeans? And we looked at it, and sure enough, it was a tick. I couldn't believe it. He just walked through the woods just maybe a block or two because he had to get off the bus and meet me there. Couldn't believe it. So when the doctor came in and I was explaining about his rash on his legs and he wanted to play football and let's see what we can do for it, the entire time, and then I said, well, here, we found this on his leg. Can you take a look at this? It was a tick. And he ran out to the nurse's station. He's got a little cup, and it had formaldehyde in it. And came back, he put the tick in, he goes, yes, that's a tick. And the entire session for my son was downplayed. It was all about the tick from that point on. My son was like looking at me, what about my rash on my leg? So I realized that, you know, doctors are now starting to understand the seriousness of it. And I was really happy that he did that with the tick and he took it very serious. What he was going to do with the tick, I don't know. So I'm here to tell you about a natural tick repellent because it is summer. And we are going to go to barbecues and we are going to walk our dogs in the wood. And Dr. Hall is going to walk her dogs in the forest. So we must be proactive. So take 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil, put it in a clean, empty shampoo bottle, and then I want you to get something called aloe vera gel, not aloe vera liquid, aloe vera gel. So you add 1 tablespoon of aloe vera gel and you shake the enclosed bottle vigorously to allow the gel to thicken. Then you want to add 25 drops of rose geranium essential oil to the mixture. I love that smell. The geranium oil, called rose geranium oil, is an essential oil. It's a natural tick repellent. They do not like the smell or the taste of that oil. And after that, you're going to add 25 drops of lavender essential oil to the mixture, and you shake that vigorously for 30 seconds. Lavender is another herb that ticks do not like the scent or the taste of. You rub this concoction, it's very strong, on your body before you go out to the forest or near trees or a barbecue or any outside event. And, of course, you have to do the other things, mm-hmm. you know, like make sure you put your socks over your pants, mm-hmm. make sure you check. I mean, those are things you have to do. But this, I found, helps, really, really helps to deter the ticks from your body.
Wow. Thank you. You know, we have just about wrapped up here today. Thank you so much for tuning us in and turning us on. Thank you, Dr. Holler. Thank you, Ronnie, for joining us. Dr. Ronnie, for joining us here today. You know, this is an ongoing progressive conversation. I want to thank both of you for joining us here today. What a great show. You bet.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you, Dr. Okay. Pat.
All right. We'll talk with everybody soon. And remember, freedom is another word for nothing left to lose. We'll see you next time on the Dr. Pat Show.
Listening to Transformation Talk Radio. Our hosts are setting a new standard for a fresh kind of talk radio, creating conversations that are transforming the world, one listener at a time. Transformation Talk Radio's mission is to broadcast a distinct blend of live talk radio interviews with a mix of uplifting and intelligent news, educational and practical information. Topics range from personal development to critical issues relevant to a rapidly changing world. Stay tuned. Transformation Talk Radio starts at the top of every hour.
Are the magic and mysteries of Egypt calling you? Picture yourself standing between the paws of the Sphinx, meditating inside the Great Pyramid and other sacred temples and exclusive visits. Imagine cruising down the Nile on a luxurious private sailing yacht and exploring the peaceful countryside of Egypt. If you're interested in travel that expands, transforms, and rejuvenates you, join Dr. Friedemann Schaub and Danielle Rama Hoffman, author of The Temples of Light, for a spiritual and healing journey to Egypt this September. Call for more information, 866-903-6463. That's 866-903-6463. Or visit EgyptIsCalling.com. That's EgyptIsCalling.com.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all. A healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. Hi, this is Dr. Darvish. If you have not found an answer to your chronic symptoms, you will find answers here at Holistic Medical Center. Our doctors find the root cause of your symptoms and guide your body towards healing naturally. We transform lives from within. Visit us at drdarvish.com. DRDARVISH.com.
What are we attracting in our life and relationships, and why? And how can we let go of attracting and being attracted to things that may not serve us? Peter Kane has been facilitating deep relationship work for over 30 years. Author of The Monogamy Challenge, Creating and Keeping Intimacy. Peter is passionate about bringing aliveness into your life and relationships. Contact Peter Kane for counseling, coaching, or breathwork. Visit peterkane.org or contact Peter Kane at 425-802-2050.
Hi, I'm Dr. Pat, and I want to share something amazing with you. If you're sick of information and ready for an extreme transformation, then check out world-renowned energy healer Ann Taylor at FasterQuickerBetter.com. She's been creating miracles in tens of thousands of people's lives for over 16 years, and I'm one of those people. You too can easily do the same by simply listening to her recordings. If you want to miraculously eliminate fears, worries, and negative beliefs, then you owe it to yourself to purchase her amazing package, which includes over 50 pieces of healing work. Thanks to Ann's 60-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. Hurry over to FasterBetterQuicker.com and finally experience the quantum leap in consciousness that you truly deserve. Hey everyone, you're listening to Transformation Talk Radio. Don't touch that dial. We'll be beginning a brand new show at the top of the hour with one of our amazing hosts, Transformation Talk Radio. Talk radio to change the world.
Ugh, aren't you tired of the same old negative vibe?
Hey, Valerie, have you heard about TransformationTalkRadio.com?
No, what's that?
Dr. Pat is launching a new network. And
Dr. Pat?
Dr. Pat.
How many hours is she going to be on?
It won't be all Dr. Pat. She'll be joined by her friends, transformative hosts from around the globe. TransformationTalkRadio.com is a 24/7 network.
24 hours of Dr. Pat and her guests?
No, 24 hours of Dr. Pat and her hosts.
Oh, my gosh, I'm so excited. Where is it going to be broadcast?
You're going to be able to hear her in Seattle, Boston, Connecticut, New York, Rhode Island, on over 300 cable radio stations, and on the Internet everywhere. Listen live at TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Great! We should spread the word.
Absolutely. Spread the word. Go to TransformationTalkRadio.com.